There is nothing worse than opening a bag of flour or a box of cereal and seeing disgusting bugs crawling around inside. These are pantry pests or stored product pests, and they're a lot more common than you might think. So in this video, I'll show you step by step how you can spot and treat for pantry pests and how to prevent them from coming back. Hi, I'm Colin with Solutions Pest Salon. If you're new to us, we create these videos to help educate people like you about DIY pest control. For the products shown in this video and to learn even more about pantry pest control, click the icon in the top right of the screen or click the links in the description below. While pantry pests don't harm people or pets, they will contaminate and spoil food, and they'll spread through your pantry quickly. So we'll go ahead and jump right in with first identifying and inspecting for pantry pests. There are many insects that can be considered pantry pests. These are insects that will infest dry foods typically stored in boxes or bags. Things like cereal, dry pasta, corn, flour, rice and other grains, spices, birdseed, and even dried fruit and dry pet food. The most common pantry pests you'll see are Indian meal moths, flour beetles, grain beetles, and weevils. To confirm pantry pest activity, look around your pantries and where foodstuff is stored. Having bugs in the kitchen is pretty common, so spotting a tiny bug crawling across your countertop is not enough. You really want to focus on that stored food, and the best way to confirm the activity is to look for the adult pantry pests themselves. So keep an eye out for moths in and around your pantry or bugs crawling around in dry food. Be sure to also check any cupboards, drawers, and shelving. You can sometimes find eggs, skin shells, or larvae in the cracks and crevices in shelving or in food, but these things are extremely small, sometimes invisible to the naked eye, so it's really best to look for the adults. When you're checking your food, look closely for any signs of movement, because some adult pantry pests are tiny, sometimes only 2 or 3 millimeters long, and they can be easy to miss. In fact, here's a piece of corn from a bag of mixed grains that we bought that was infested with grain beetles. You can see how small this dead beetle is. Here are some crawling on the table after pouring some of the grain out. Weevils are a little bigger and easier to spot. We found this guy crawling around a second bag of mixed grain. Now you might be wondering, how did I get pantry pests in the first place? While it's possible that some pests like moths or weevils can come in from outside, the most likely reason is that you bought infested food at the grocery store and brought them in. Most of the time, that bag of flour or rice that you just bought was harboring these pests. Even if you didn't see the adults crawling around, the eggs and larvae could have been in there, going unnoticed. Don't forget, you can learn more and get your professional pesticides for pantry pest control by clicking the link in the description below. Now that you have confirmed pantry pest activity, it's time to begin treatment. The first thing you need to do is throw out all of your contaminated food. We know it's hard throwing away that 10-pound bag of rice you just bought, but pantry pest infestations can spread rapidly. Now you could go through and check all of your food packaging for signs of damage or activity, but it's really best to just throw away all of your boxed or bagged dry food stuff. Because if one package is infested, it's safe to assume they all are. After you've thrown out the food, completely remove everything else from the pantry. Next, vacuum all cracks and crevices in the pantry, shelving, or cabinets. If your shelving is adjustable, clean out the peg holes with a toothpick and vacuum. These tight spaces are notorious for collecting moth eggs and webbing. Be sure to throw out the vacuum's bag or clean the canister when you're done. Then wipe all of the pantry's shelving with mild soap and water to clean up any food residue. By sanitizing your pantry and food storage and throwing out all of the contaminated food, you'll be cutting off the head of your pantry pest infestation. Next, it's time for chemical control. You'll need a combination of aerosol insecticide and glue traps. And please, don't forget your personal protective equipment when using any pesticides, especially in a tight, confined space like pantries. First, use Novacide aerosol. Novacide is an aerosol insecticide that is labeled to control common pantry pests like rice weevils, sawtooth grain beetles, and moths. But it'll also control many other pests found in the home, such as ants, fleas, ticks, and cockroaches. What's great about Novacide is that it has a long-lasting residual and a built-in insect growth regulator. This is key because not only will it kill any adult pests that come into contact with it, but it'll also stop young insects from growing into adults, breaking the pest's life cycle and stopping a reinfestation. Shake the can well and hold at a downward angle. You're just going to spot treat the back and sides of the shelving all the way around the pantry. Spot spray the shelving in quick bursts so a fine mist is applied. If you have cracks and crevices where the shelf meets the wall, then the Novacide will treat these areas, killing any pests that might be harboring there. When you're done, don't re-enter or allow others to enter the treated area until it's dry and the vapors have dispersed. You can restock the pantry once it's dried. Next, use Pro Pest Pantry Moth and Beetle Traps. This is a ready-to-use, pesticide-free trap that uses a pheromone-scented glue board to trap pantry pests. Simply remove the protecting paper from the pre-baited glue and fold the trap into a pyramid shape. Place the trap on the pantry shelving where it won't get smashed and will be left generally undisturbed and out of the reach of children and pets. The trap's pheromone bait will lure adult pantry pests to the trap where they'll get stuck in the glue. This is a great, low-effort tool and will last between 60 and 90 days. And one trap will cover 100 square feet. Finally, for stubborn pantry pests that slip by previous treatments, use Pyrid. This is an aerosol insecticide that is labeled for mini pests and delivers a quick kill. Unlike Novicide, Pyrid does not leave a residual, but is instead used as a knockdown spray. This can be applied as a direct or space spray to any pest in the pantry. Pyrid is safe to use in pantries that hold packaged foods, but please remember to remove any food that the spray could come into direct contact with. Also, don't forget to cover up any dishes, utensils, or cooking equipment before spraying, or wash them thoroughly after spraying. Just like with Novicide, don't re-enter or allow others to enter the area until it's dry or the vapors have dispersed. And with any aerosol product, please be mindful of any open flames or hot surfaces, as the propellants and aerosols are extremely flammable. Get these products today by clicking the icon in the top right of the screen, where you can easily find each of the products. We also have links to the products down in the description below. Once you have finished treating your pantry, then it's time to start thinking about prevention. If you follow the control steps, then you're off to a great start. Novicide's long residual and IGR will go a long way in keeping your pantry free of any pests. And the ProPest traps are good for up to 3 months, so switching them out quarterly will take care of any adult pantry pests that are accidentally brought in. Here are some other prevention tips. If you can, buy only about a week or two's worth of food at a time. Pantries that hold foods for extended periods of time are more likely to see an infestation. When buying dry foods at the grocery store, take a look at the packaging. If you see any holes, rips, tears, or other openings, don't buy that package. And when storing food, it's best to keep them in tight-fitting or sealed containers. Put cereals, rice, and flour in containers that can be air-sealed. This is especially true for pet food. Dry pet food and birdseed are extremely conducive for pantry pests, so put your pet's food in containers. Be sure to visit our website for an in-depth pantry pest control guide and to get access to each of these products. We guarantee these products 100%. We also offer same-day shipping so you can get control quickly. Solutions is a small, family-owned business, and we rely on referrals from customers like you. So if you like this how-to guide and when the products work for you, please share and tell your friends and family about us. I'm Colin with Solutions Pest and Lawn. Ask us how, and then do it yourself.